Mr. O'Leary is there. Michael, good afternoon.
Afternoon, Joe. How are you?
Good, and you?
I'm great, thank you.
Okay, now you promise this time you're on Liveline you won't tell lies, Michael.
I've never yet told a lie on Liveline.
Yes, you have.
Joe.
Yes, you have.
Not true.
Yes, you have.
No,
it is true. You came on this
it
program.
Isn't true.
It is true. You came on this program 4 or 5 years ago. We had complaints from a group of passengers.
10 years ago.
A group, so you remember now. So a group of passengers from Luton who missed their flight for a Ryanair flight. They came on saying it wasn't announced as they were told it would be, and it didn't come up on the board as they were told it would be. You came on and said absolutely, totally, completely untrue. You accused them of being liars, and then we got the information from Luton Airport itself, which disproved what you said. Do you remember that, Michael?
That was completely untrue, Joe.
Do you remember?
I do, well, vaguely remember.
Okay.
The information you got from Luton Airport wasn't correct.
Okay. But, so everyone is lying.
No. That's
all
not true.
You said this morning.
25 million.
I know that.
But can we deal with what you want to deal with now, which is the allocated seating?
Yes, sorry, Joe.
Let Carol speak. Go ahead,
Carol. There, but I didn't see any 2 euro seats or 4 euro seats.
Correct,
to be reserved.
Because they've already been reserved.
Well, there must have been only about two of them.
No, there's actually 36 €2 seats on every flight, and there's about another 64 euro seats on every flight. The point you're missing is that most of the passengers who are now reserving those seats do so when they made their original booking. When did you make your booking?
Oh, I made my booking in February. That's the point.
When somebody else made their booking in February, they booked the 2 euro seat and the 4 euro seat.
Point to you that up to
next week, we will announce our first quarter results, and the average fares for all of the passengers who've flown with us in the last 3 months have fallen by 8%. More than 4 euros a passenger. Every single passenger is enjoying lower fares traveling with Ryanair. Every passenger, when you make a booking, including you, Carol, when you booked in February, was given the choice. And you actually exercised your choice in February. Do you want to reserve a seat from 2 euros? Not 4, but from 2 euros. You clicked the button to say, no, I want a random seat. It was your choice.
Let Michael finish, Carol.
At the time in February, clicked to say, no, I want to reserve my seat. I want to select the 2 euro seats or the 4 euro reserve seats. And it's a bit rich for you to come back in 5 months later whinging because you didn't take up the option in February. It's your choice. If you've made the choice, stop whinging afterwards.
Okay. Now, Michael, the second element of it is, that this is the situation that people have been saying to us. If after buying your flight and obviously seeing the price of it, you do not pay extra for a seat, you will be penalised as follows. A, if you have children under 12 with you, they will not be allowed to fly if the adult doesn't pay extra for the seat. Isn't that correct?
No, absolutely untrue.
So the adult, every parent...
Sorry, the adult will not be allowed to make the booking with children under 12 unless they buy the reserve seat.
That's my point.
It's not that we...
You will not sell them the tickets. The whole family. Okay. Now, the second point is, if people over 12 on the same booking reference, be it a family or a group or pals or whatever, a group of old age pensioners, whatever, if everyone over 12 on the same booking reference does not buy, after they buy their ticket, does not pay extra for a reserved seat, they will be dispersed throughout the plane, despite there being vacant seats nearby. That's the allegation.
No, and I think that's where the misunderstanding is. This idea there will be vacant seats nearby. There aren't vacant
seats
nearby.
We've had loads of examples, Michael.
You don't have loads of examples. What you're seeing is passengers who, when they go in to book their random seat, which you can do 4 days before travel, there appears to be lots of seats available. There isn't lots of seats available because many of those seats have already been reserved. but the passenger hasn't come back in yet to take up their reserved seat. We fly, our aircraft are flying at the moment with 96% load factors, Joe. There are no empty seats unless a passenger has no show.
But again and again, Michael, our listeners, your customers and our listeners, we have 400,000 every day, they're telling us that previously on Ryanair, if they booked together and the one booking reference, Ryanair would do their utmost to try and seat you together. The situation is now...
That's not correct.
But that was people's experience.
I'm sorry, but I've flown with you for years and I have never, ever, ever had an issue whereby when we booked online and we checked in online that we weren't allocated seats in three across and then one in the next.
Carol, that's not correct. For about 2 years, we have had a policy of offering people who want to reserve a seat can select their seat, and people who chose, as you did, a random seat were given a random seat. And I frankly don't understand you're complaining about
Michael, you completely reject the allegation that the algorithm is configured as such that if people on the same booking ref do not buy seats after they buy their ticket, do not pay extra for seats after they buy their ticket, you completely reject that the algorithm is configured in such a way at the moment that they are then deliberately dispersed throughout the plane despite there being spare or vacant seats available.
Good. Can I deal with a couple of things?
Is that true?
It's untrue. But firstly, what has the same booking reference got to do with anything?
Mrs. Murphy in number 87 doesn't call around to Mrs. Maguire at 18 roads back and say, will we book it together even though we're not going? The same booking reference means people are travelling together, Michael. Stress,
it doesn't
airports,
so,
it does.
Okay, if I have a group of 15 people travelling on the same booking reference, Joe, do you expect them all to sit together?
Heretofore, the story has been that Ryanair would always do the best. Now it would seem, story after story, if you don't pay the premium after you buy the ticket,
you have a tiny number of stories compared to our 400,000 daily passengers.
Okay.
Here's what's actually happening.
400,000 daily listeners.
Has the algorithm changed? No, it hasn't. The algorithm changes automatically on an hourly, every hour, every day, every week. The algorithm changes as demand for reserved seats changes. Are you likely to be split up if you select a random seat? Yes, you are likely to be split up because that's what random means. If you want to sit specifically in a seat, you select a reserved seat from just €2.
That's less than the cost
of the RTE license fee increase.
Michael, can I just say to you, on this thing of random seats, okay?
Yes.
So you're saying to me then that myself and my family over the last 3 years flying with Ryanair each time have been incredibly lucky that our random seats actually landed beside one another?
What's happened in the last 2 years, we started off selling reserve seats, and in the first year about 10% of passengers bought a reserve seat, so there was 90% of the seats available for random allocation, Carol. What's happening now is more than 50% of the seats are taken up by passengers paying €2 for a reserve seat. There are fewer and fewer
random seats. It has changed.
An algorithm, Joe, changes all the time. That's what an algorithm is. We don't go in and change the algorithm. The algorithm changes because the number of reserved seats has all changed. You have to pay for it because we require you to sit beside the child. You can buy the seat from €4 and the number of children sitting beside you will be allocated free.
If
the children are under 12, the gentleman will have to pay the €4. He has to have a reserved seat because we must ensure that the adult travels with children under 12. I don't see what the difficulty is. No, the seats for the kids are free. They pay nothing for the seats for the children under 12.
Okay, but Michael, listen,
sorry, Joe. Have we got a sensible question you want to ask?
So what do you mean by that? Sorry. What do you mean by that, as a matter of interest? I'm an adult, the same as you're an adult. I went to the same college as you went. I have the same education.
We have a very simple policy here. How dare you?
Have you a sensible question?
Yes.
Do you want to rephrase that?
No, I don't.
You want to apologise for saying that?
We have a very simple policy here. If you wanted to choose a random seat, you will get a random seat entirely free of charge. And if you want to select a reserve seat, it would be €2, Joe. What part of that don't you understand?
The point that's being made again and again, that's not the issue.
Which is wrong.
After booking, the situation is simple. After booking and buying your seat on Ryanair, then, if you do not pay extra for a seat...
A free of charge random seat, that's right. Exactly what you will be allocated.
And if you choose not to pay extra, if you have children, the ticket cannot be sold, okay? Isn't that correct?
Correct. Yes, we
ticket won't allow will not you be sold, so you will be penalised.
No, you won't be penalised. You won't be allowed to travel.
Aidan Carlis. Aidan, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Maybe.
Michael, will you admit there's a change in policy?
There was a change in policy 2 years ago when we started selling reserve seats. Has there been a change in policy in recent weeks? No, there hasn't.
So why then are people being displaced? People who would normally sit beside each other.
This is, I think, your misunderstanding. People don't normally sit beside each other. If you select a reserve seat, you're free to sit with your partner. And if you select a free of charge random seat, it is now increasingly unlikely you would be sitting with your partner because that's what you chose.
Michael, whether you admit it or not, there's a change of policy. Second.
That's because we can create more space for the people who want to pay for a reserve seat to select their reserve seat. No.
Yes.
Yeah. I'm mystified how it's all about money in a year when we're lowering the airfares.
Everybody got a free seat.
What we used to do for years was nobody got a seat. Everybody had to queue up at the boarding gate and run down to try and find whatever seat they could get.
Yeah.
When we moved about 4 years ago back to pre-allocated seating, and 2 years ago we introduced reserve seating so that those customers who wanted to pay extra to select their seat could do so, and those customers who by choice said, we don't mind where we sit, we'll take any random seat, they can do that entirely free of charge. We have more than 65 million people who choose to reserve a seat. More than 50% of our customers want to choose their seat. If they don't want to choose it, Aidan, then they'll simply say, we don't care, we'll take whatever seat we get, and that will be free of charge. It's called choice. I don't know why you kind of somehow underestimate that that's what customers wish to do. Some people want an aisle seat. Some people want a window seat.
But
we have 65 million customers this year who suggest that you're wrong.
Okay, well, it
starts from €2, Joe.
Even if they all were the extra two euro, which they're not, that could be an extra 125 million. That could be an extra, Thomas in Northern Ireland.
Anyway, sorry, while you're doing that and those maths, Joe, the 130 million passengers this year will pay €4 less for their fare, which is about €600 million saved by passengers flying with Ryanair this year. So let's accept that there's a disproportionate voice given here on Liveline to people who have exercised the choice for a free of charge random seat and then somehow want to complain about that choice. About 2 years ago, we changed the policy 2 years ago. There has been no change in the policy since that. The only people complaining are the people who have chosen a reserve seat free of charge and then somehow want to come back after the event, as Carol has done, and said, oh, now I want to change my mind or I'll complain. That's fine. You're perfectly free to complain, but that's the policy. The only point I'm making is the policy hasn't changed. What is changing is the demand for the reserve seat, which continues to increase. Well, sorry. Firstly, my apology you didn't get your seat, but what's wrong about the instance you get? And I can't deal with an individual specific case, but our system does not allow somebody with a... And we have the passport numbers. Children under the age of 12 cannot be booked into the front row or into the overwing exits. It doesn't happen. The system doesn't allow it. I will happily refund you the cost of your allocated seats. Write to me and I'll investigate that flight. But it wasn't because a child under the age of 12 booked into the front row or the overwing exits. The system doesn't allow that to happen.
Now, Michael, the other point that's been raised here, and I quote from... I think it was the London Times on Saturday. It was a case in the UK. Robin Kiley, Ryanair's head of communications, said this is about that lunatic Twitter fella who issued a threat and you rightly went after him. Ryanair's head of communications, the safety of our customers, people and aircraft is our number one priority and we will not allow anyone to impugn, threaten or undermine our 32-year unblemished safety record. Now, one of our callers made the point, and I know you dismissed it out of hand this morning, but I'll put it to you again, that if families are separated because they weren't willing to pay the extra money after they bought the flight, to actually be seated together, even though they're on the one booking reference. If families are separated throughout the plane, dispersed throughout the plane, and there's big differences, front, back, middle, there didn't seem to be any effort to seat them together, or even close together. If families are separated, and there is, God forbid, an emergency disembarkation.
If the family, if people choose a random seat, they get a random seat. We simply give them what they've chosen. Now, dealing with an emergency evacuation, in an emergency evacuation, everybody on board the aircraft is ordered by the cabin crew to get off the plane immediately. If they have relatives on board the plane, they can meet them on the ramp or on the tarmac once they've offloaded. But we don't wait in an emergency evacuation for can I talk to my uncle over there in 16 rows? It's everybody off the plane. That's what an emergency evacuation is.
And even if a parent panics and said, I can't see my child, she could be in the toilet.
If the child is under 12, Joe, the parent could be sitting beside the child.
Oh, I know that. But
right,
like,
so if you know that, then I don't
know. 13, a 14, a 15, a 16 year old?
And so the teenager,
13, 14, 15, 16.
Who the parent has chose to sit randomly, they will be.
So it's their hard luck
exactly
if they can't
the
see.
Same,
them.
They will be afforded exactly the same courtesy as every other passenger and gotten off the plane with the shortest possible delay. The parents can find the teenager on the ramp or on the bus immediately at the
airport. I know that, but I'm saying
they will not be running around looking for each other during emergency evacuation. But you'll be glad to know that we had only one emergency evacuation the entire of last year, during which we operated almost a million flights. So it so rarely happens. I don't know why you're wasting time on the example.
Yeah, but you want it never to happen. Yes.
And when
yes,
it doesn't,
and,
when it
and we
happens,
don't want it to go wrong.
Those people who have been chosen to sit randomly will be afforded exactly the same courtesy as customers who are seated together in an emergency evacuation, which will be everybody off the aircraft immediately.
Okay, I've got to take a quick break. Can you hold on, Michael O'Leary, please?
Delighted to, Joe. If we had changed the policy on free seating and allocated seating, we would tell you we changed the policy. We don't have anything to hide. Because, listen, I'm trying to explain a couple of times, right? Because more and more people are buying reserved seats. They're selecting the seat they want at the time of the booking. We now have more than 50% of passengers who are doing that. So there is fewer and fewer reserved seats left over for the people. We used to have free seating where nobody had an allocated seat.
What does low fares made simple, always getting better?
Yep.
Like, what does that mean in English?
It means, Joe, that this year 130 million passengers.
I feel like I'm just pulling a string on a Barbie doll half the time. I get the same answer.
I know, but it
what I'm saying to you is it suits you to demean
the response.
I'm not.
What it means, and let me answer the question, is everybody flying with Ryanair this year is paying a lower fare. More than 65 million of our passengers who want to select a specific seat can now do so by paying from €2 up to €15 to do so, and the 65 million passengers who don't want to pay for that seat and who are happy with a random seat are given that random seat entirely free of charge. Yeah, that's what always getting better means.
Are people
and
being deliberately dispersed?
People are not being deliberately dispersed, Joe, but they are highly likely to be dispersed if they choose a random seat.
Can you tell the algorithm if people are on the same booking reference and if they don't pay a premium, do your best, computer, to actually seat them as close as possible to each other?
No, the system won't do that. But the system also isn't told, do your best to split them up as far as it possibly can.
No, but the system is told, keep the aisle seat and the window seat free as late as possible, because that's where we're going to make our extra money.
Absolutely.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah. Perfectly correct.
Okay. Well, that's it. That's it. That's
yeah. No
that's
question.
That's the clarity. Okay. 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 Any other?
That's a customer. As Robin said, that is a customer choice. You've chosen
if
to
you
buy
pay the extra
seat.
Yeah. You buy a ticket and you're.
And if you don't
you
want
pay
to pay
extra.
The extra, that's no problem. You don't have to pay the extra. But then don't turn around afterwards
okay.
And complain
and the point is,
somebody.
And if you don't pay the extra under that algorithm which you've now installed, that means that
so
more than likely you will be penalised because you won't be sitting close, even though there are.
Why do you keep repeating the same thing? I've already said we changed the system two years ago. Has there been a change in the last 2 years? No, there hasn't. It's just that more and more people are. What's happened, and as I've explained a couple of times, is that more and more people are now buying their preferred reserve seats. There is fewer seats available
because
for random
know.
Passengers. I've repeatedly admitted, Carol, that what has changed is the number of people who are selecting and paying for reserve
because
seats.
Because they know
has gone from 10% to 50%
because
of passengers.
Because they know if you don't pay the extra.
Not per person
if you don't pay the extra, you will be dispersed.
If you choose a random seat, then you will have a free of charge random seat.
Yeah, and if
there
you
is
don't,
no penalty.
If you don't,
it's called customer choice.
If you don't, families over.
They will get exactly what they selected, which was a random seat.
They'll be dispersed throughout the plane.
Random seats.
Okay, I thought about 5 minutes ago you did accept that, but maybe.
No.
Okay, Michael, I do appreciate your...
We give customers exactly what they want.
Okay.
Free of charge random seats, or they can select their own seats.
And low fares made simple.
And low fares for everybody. €4 off every single seat this year.
Is the made simple gone?
Couldn't be simpler. That's why we're growing so strongly.
Okay. Well, nobody doubts that, and continued success.
And I'd like to thank Carol and Mary and everybody else for flying with us this year and saving more money while they're flying with us.
Okay.
Oh, I don't know about that, Michael. The jury's still out on that one. I'll let you know.
Well, Mary, you can check the fares. You can check the fares with any of our competitors. You'll find we're way cheaper than them.
Okay. Michael O'Leary, thanks indeed.
Thanks, Joe.
Kind regards to
and your
family.
Thank you very much.